now to the two co-features of the evening. The co-feature about between Mikey Garcia and Elio Rojas is sort of intriguing. And Mikey Garcia, 34-0 with 28 KOs out of Oxnard, trained by his brother, one of the best in the game, former world champion Robert Garcia. He's been out for a long time. He's had a long layoff, but he's ready to come back and regain the trajectory he had when he was active. And that was a trajectory toward the top of the pound-for-pound ratings and the top of stardom in boxing. You know, he could be coming back against a nobody, because frankly, he would have been given that slack with that kind of time off. Instead, he's coming back against a guy who also sort of has an intriguing story over the last couple of years. Elio Rojas is a former world champion. He's been very inactive over the last 4 years himself. He's had that grand slam of promotional issues, managerial issues, immigration issues, and then some inactivity due to injury and waiting for an opportunity. And here's the opportunity he's been waiting for, and it's against the star coming back, a guy in much the same situation as he is, moving up in weight, and with a lot of people wanting to see what both of these gentlemen have in the tank right now. So first, the former world champion, former featherweight champion of the world from the Dominican Republic, and now fighting out of Bronx, Elio Rojas.
Buenas tardes. Gracias a Luz Rivera por la oportunidad. A Showtime. La familia García por elegirme como. Realmente estoy contento por la gran oportunidad que se me brinda para estar en este show. Sé que me traen como luchador oponente, pero quiero dejar claro esta tarde que yo no soy luchador oponente de nadie. También quisiera dejar claro que sé quién es Mikey García.
I would like to make it real clear that I know who Mikey Garcia is.
Y que estoy claro de que también tengo todas las cualidades para poder vencer el 30 de julio.
And I'm also clearly that I have all the abilities to win on July 3rd.
Siempre he sido un luchador que no ha sido protegido.
I'm always been a boxer who never protected.
Pero siempre me preparo para ganar mis peleas y esta no es la excepción.
But I always do prepare to win the fight, and this is not going to be an exception.
Pasen un feliz día y gracias.
Have a blessed day and thank you very much.
Without further ado, the former WBO featherweight champion of the world, the former WBO super featherweight champion of the world, a guy that has wins over, I think, 7 or 8 former world champions, so his record is quite amazing. Coming off a long layoff, so we all want to see him back in the ring, Mikey Garcia.
Well, first, thank everybody for joining us here. It's been a while since I've done this, but I'm very excited to be back. I do want to thank Steven Espinosa with Showtime for allowing me to come back, Lou DiBella for putting me on the great show, great night, great champions on the card, and also Mr. Al Heyman for giving me this opportunity, organizing this. What else can I say? I mean, everybody has said it all. You know, we're ready. We're prepared. Had a very good training camp. I know Elio Rojas is a great champion. He's got the boxing skills to make it complicated. But I'm a better fighter. I'm a better champion. I got better skills than anybody who put in front of me. And I will show that again on Saturday night. And this will only be the beginning of the next stage of my career, which will be the most memorable stage of my career. Thank you very much.
doesn't really get much better than the main event on the show. I mean, this is one of the elite matchups that can be made in the entire sport. In my mind, one of the most exciting potential matchups of the year. Has that same kind of potential that Thurman Porter had to be a Fight of the Year candidate, because these are two amazing fighters. And the winner of this fight is not just going to win, well, retain or win the featherweight champion. The winner of this fight is going to have a pretty strong argument to say, I'm pound for pound. That's how good a matchup this is. First, I'd like to bring up a man who's in the Hall of Fame. He's training the challenger in this fight, but the man he's training is a unified 122-pound champion. In my mind, very possibly the best pound-for-pound fighter in the UK. So it's my pleasure to bring up Hall of Famer, trainer, and manager Barry McGuigan.
Thank you, Lou. I'm the manager. Shane McGuigan is the trainer. We're delighted to be here in Manhattan in this potential fight of the year. I'd like to thank a couple of people. Al Heyman, obviously. Udo Bell has been fantastic with his team, and we're thrilled to be here. And I want to make this comment. I know that Leo's dad has been unwell recently with cancer. Every one of our families are affected by cancer, so we're thrilled that he's back on his feet and he's stronger than ever. Obviously, I want to thank Stephen Espinosa and Showtime. We do a wonderful job. Thrilled to be here. This is potentially, no matter what way you throw it up and mix it about, this is the two clash of styles, makes it potentially fight of the year. This guy's got a great reputation. We have the utmost respect for him. But we're here to win, and we will win.
And we are pleased to have Jose Santa Cruz here with us, and he doesn't want to say anything, but he looks well, and we're very happy that he looks well. And one thing about boxing is, we are a family, and in this family, everybody's prayers, everybody's good thoughts and positive wishes are with you, Jose, and with your whole family. The challenger in this fight is a champion himself, the Jackal. One of the best fighters in boxing. My honor and pleasure to bring up Carl Frampton.
Thanks everyone for the great turnout. I just want to thank a few people, well, everyone really involved in making this fight. DiBella, Cyclone Promotions, Showtime, and Al Heyman as well. I want to give a couple of guys that are on the undercard of Manson. They're part of my team, Conrad Cummings and Josh Taylor as well, two good fighters for the future. I'm looking forward to a top quality fight. I really respect Leo Santa Cruz. He's a fighter who I have respected and admired for a long time. I believe this is easily the toughest fight of my career, but I also believe that this will be the toughest fight of Leo's career. I put her very, very hard in the gym. I'm in good shape. I'm feeling much stronger at 126 pounds. And I'm very privileged and honored to be top on a bill with such great fighters, Mikey Garcia, Paulie Malignaggi, the rest of the guys. There's probably four fights that could top a bill on their own right. So I'm honored to be topping the bill with such a great fighter, but I'm coming to win. Thank you.
It's impossible to love boxing and not be a fan of Leo Santa Cruz, because he fights with fire, fights with passion. His work rate's unbelievable. He's just fun to watch. And, you know, I'm proud to promote him. It's the first time I've ever had a chance to promote a Leo Santa Cruz fight, so I'm happy about that. But I've been a fan for a long time because this young man is pure excitement. The featherweight champion of the world, Leo Santa Cruz.
First of all, good afternoon to everyone. And muy buenas tardes a todos. First of all, I want to give thanks, you know, I'm always going to be grateful to this person my whole life. You know, my manager, Al Heyman, you know, not only he is my manager, but, you know, he's like family to me. He's like another fellow to me. He's always there for me for whatever I need. And he's always right there, like, teasing me whatever I want. So I want to thank him, and I'm going to be thankful for him. I also want to thank Showtime, you know, Frank Espinosa. You know, I want to Lou De Bella. You know, my whole family that's here with me. My whole team. We have a big team, so I want to thank my whole team. I want to thank the Watson's brothers, you know, Sam Watson. I want to thank Andy. I want to thank my strength conditioning coach, Andy Aguilar, that he got me in the best shape, you know, my life to be here and give a great fight. I want to give thanks to my massage therapist, Vanessa. Thank you. I want to thank also my photographer, Raymond Rodriguez. There's a lot of people I want to give thanks to, you know. I want to give thanks to other people. And also, but you know, also another person, my dad, you know, right now. At the beginning, when they told us he had cancer, we were even thinking about not taking this fight, you know, because me not having my dad with me, it would have been devastating, you know. Like, he's always been there with me since the beginning of my career, since I was very small. I remember him, me and him walking towards the bus to catch the bus to go to the gym. And yes, imagine not having him in the corner. It was something that really hard for me that I wasn't going to be able to take. So, you know, the first thing I said, if my dad's going to be in my fight, in my corner, I will take the fight. And so we talked to the doctors, and they gave us big hopes. They told us that he was going to be good, that he was going to be able to be in my corner. So when they told me that, I said, well, let's take the fight. As long as my dad is there, I'm happy. And also another person I want to thank is Luis Rodriguez, because if it wasn't for him, my dad wouldn't have been able to be here, because he was the one that found out that he had cancer. And right away, since he found out that, he took it to the doctor, he got everything done for him, he started his chemos, he started, you know, his radiation, he got the surgery done, and everything is really, really done. Even like the doctors and they were surprised because he was getting everything done. So I want to thank Luis Rodriguez for everything, for having me here. You know, Carl Frampton, like I said, he's a great fighter, you know. I respect him too. He has everything to become to be a great world champion. He has great footwork, great punches, great power, and I respect that. And that's very good because, you know, it's going to be a more interesting fight because we're both undefeated. We will come with everything to not get that first loss. So we're going to go out there in the ring and make it a war. I think, like I said, even if we could, you know, we gonna give our lives up there in the ring. We're gonna do that yet to get the win. So I know this is gonna be my toughest fight of my career. It's not gonna be no easy fight. And this fight could be a 50-50 fight. It could go either way. So I think the fighter that wants it the most, that trains the hardest, and is gonna win that night. So hopefully, I just wanna, you know, ask that hope both of us come out healthy from the fight, that there's no injuries or no like bad things. So I wanna thank you and invite all the fans, you know, all the Mexican people that are here, all the Latino people, the Puerto Ricans, Dominicans, to come watch us, to support me, and hopefully we do a great fight. Thank you, guys.
We're going to pause the fighters. They'll be available for one-on-ones. One quick thing that we've already established, my memory's gone, so I failed to mention that Sergey Rabchenko is promoted by Warriors Boxing. I see my friend Leon Marto is there. Thanks for being here, Leon. Tickets are still available. I'm happy that tickets have been moving really, really well in the last couple of days, but tickets are still available. This is like a once-in-a-lifetime kind of fight card. I mean, the kind of fight card you can come to at 5 o'clock in the evening and spend the entire night being entertained. Guys, just 1 second. Come on. Just 1 second, I'll be done. It's really the kind of fight card you can come to and see competitive, non-stop action for hour after hour after hour. So like, you know, if you're a casual fight fan, it's been hot as hell, get out of the heat, come into the air conditioning. Saturday, the weather's not supposed to be so great. You know, join us, come out to this card because it's as good as it gets. If you can't be there, it's a night to watch Showtime Extreme. Turn on your TV at 7 p.m. Eastern time for Showtime Extreme, followed by Showtime at 9 p.m. This is the best against the best. This is the best that boxing can be yet again. This is a great night for boxing. See you Saturday night. Thank you.
Down in front.
Lisa, Lisa.
Watch that phone.
Robert, the other, I'm trying to take it out of the way.